show you our operational amplifier designer trainer kit. Order code is 36197. So this is the trainer kit. This is our two op amp IC741. These are the various resistors given here. These are the capacitors. These two are Zener diode of 3.3 volt. These three are diodes, sorry, these four are diodes IN414A. This is a LED. This is a toggle switch. These are the variable DC power supply, 0 to 2 volt at 20 milliampere. This is a fixed power supply of plus minus 15 volt. This is a SL100 transistor. This is a lamp and this is a 10K potentiometer. This is a main switch to turn on or off the kit. This is user manual and patch ports are included in this kit. To do the experiments, we will need a CRO and a multimeter. So our first operation is op amp as an inverting amplifier. For this, we are going to build this circuit here. So first, give plus 15 volt power supply to terminal 7 and minus 15 volt power supply to terminal 4. Now connect terminal 2 with a power supply with the help of a 1K resistor. Give feedback with the help of a 10K resistor to terminal 2. Connect terminal 3 to ground with the help of a 1K resistor. So connect this to ground and we will observe the output. Terminal 6. So first we will check the input voltage. Make sure that the input voltage does not go beyond 1.5 volt, because then the op amp will go in saturation mode. So my input voltage is 0.38. Now we will check the voltage at the output terminal of op amp. We can see that the voltage is minus 3.86. This is the inverting. This is the voltage is in minus polarity, negative polarity, and the voltage is the 10 times of input voltage. Our next experiment is op amp operation as subtractor and differential amplifier. So this is the circuit diagram that we are going to build. So first give 15 volt power supply to this terminal and negative power supply to this terminal, minus 15 volt power supply. Now connect terminal 2 to power supply with the help of a 10K resistor. We'll connect terminal 3 with another power supply with the help of a 10K resistor. So this is our E2 and this is our E1. Now we will connect terminal 3 to the ground with the help of a 100K resistor. And we'll give feedback to the input terminal 2 with the help of a 100K resistor. Now we will connect this to ground. No. Now before starting the experiment, we will observe the voltage of the two power supply. So I am giving
1
So first we will check the voltage. So turn on the key and I am giving. Voltage point around 0.40. Now we will also check this voltage. So I will give this voltage around 0.5. So this is the voltage I am giving. Now we will observe. Now we will observe the voltage at the output terminal. So we can see that the voltage is around 1.5. So the output voltage is 10 times into difference of these two input voltage. So this is subtractor, op amp as a subtractor. Our next experiment is to see the op amp as a pulse generator. So for this we are going to bend this circuit here. So first we will give positive power supply to terminal 7 and negative power supply to terminal 4. Now connect terminal 2 to 150 k-ohms and connect this to ground. Now we will connect a capacitor from terminal 2. Value is 0.01 microfarad and we will also connect this to ground. Now connect terminal 3 with the help of a connect terminal 3 to ground with the help of a 100k resistor like this. Now from the 100k resistor we will connect another resistor 100k and we will connect this to the potentiometer here. Sorry, we will connect this to a power supply positive power supply and we will give this power supply to this potentiometer. Now connect this terminal to plus 15 volt power supply. And we will connect this to ground. Now from terminal 3 we will connect this to terminal 6 with the help of a 100k resistor. Now again we will connect a diode IN4148 from the cathode of this diode. We will connect a resistor 33k and we will connect this to terminal 2. Now we will observe the output waveform in terminal 6. Also connect this to ground. We can see the output waveform. So this is op amp as a pulse generator. Our next experiment is square and triangular wave generator, So this is the circuit diagram that we are going to build. So first connect terminal 2 to ground with the help of a 5.1k resistor. Now connect terminal 6 with a 1k resistor . Connect this with a 10k resistor and connect this resistor with the terminal 2 of second op amp. Now from this op amp, from terminal 2 of the second op amp, connect a capacitor of 0.1 microfarad and connect the other terminal of the capacitor with the output terminal of second op amp. Now connect this terminal 3 to ground. Now from this resistor, that is connected with the output terminal, connect this to terminal 3 of the first op amp. Now from this resistor 1K which is connected at the output terminal of first op amp, connect a 10K resistor and connect this with terminal 3 of the first op amp. Now from this resistor connect another 10K resistor and connect this to terminal 6 of the second op amp. Now we will give power supply, so give 15 volt to terminal 7 and we will give negative power supply to terminal 4. We will do the same connection for the second op amp. Now we will connect these two diode here, Zener diode 3.3 volt. So first we will connect this cathode of the diode to ground connection. Now we will connect this anode with the other anode of the diode and this cathode of the diode will be connected with 10K resistor that is connected with the first output, connected with the output terminal of the first op amp. Now we will observe the voltage, we will observe the output waveform at terminal 6 of first op amp and terminal 6 of second op amp and here at this cathode of the diode. Output waveform across the output terminal of the first op amp, this is a square waveform. Now what's the waveform? Here across the diode, and we can see this is also a square waveform. Now we will watch the waveform at the output terminal of the second op amp. We can see this is a triangular waveform. So first we are going to give 15 volt power supply to terminal 7 and we will ground terminal 4. Now we are going to give, we will connect terminal 2 with a resistance 5K1, this is R2 and we will ground this. Now again from terminal 2 we will connect another resistance, this is also 5.1 kilo ohm and we will connect this with output. This is the feedback loop. Now we will connect terminal 3. Okay, first before connecting terminal 3, from terminal 6 we will connect a resistor 1K and from 1K we will connect this with a Zener diode, cathode of the Zener diode here 3.3 volt and we will connect the anode to the ground.
Now from terminal 3 we will connect, we'll short this resistor and diode junction. So this one, so connect this to here with this terminal of the resistor. Now we will observe the voltage at E0 and E01 and E02. So E01 is here and E02 is here at terminal 6. So connect this here. First we are going to connect it here to see the voltage E01. So we can see that the voltage is around 3.19. Now connect this to terminal 6 and we can see that the voltage is around 6.36. So this is the voltage E02 is actually E01 into R2 plus R3 by R2. So if you calculate this you will get E02. So you can do it theoretically and verify this with your with the result. Experiment is to see the op amp as to observe output displays for comparator. So for this we will first do LED driver experiment. So for this we are going to build this connection here. There is figure 80. So first we are going to connect 7 terminal 7 to positive power supply and terminal 4 to negative power supply. Now we will connect terminal 2 with a 10K resistor and we will connect this terminal at here at this potentiometer. Now connect one of the terminal of this potentiometer to ground and connect the other terminal of this potentiometer to a 22K resistor. Now connect this 22K resistor with a 10K resistor and ground this terminal of the 10K resistor. Now from terminal 3 we will connect a 10K resistor and from this we will connect it here at the junction of 22K resistor and 10K resistor. Now this terminal will be connected with a 2.2 kilo ohm resistor and this terminal will be connected with the LED and ground the output of the LED. Now as I am giving the comparator in as my comparator input is high, the LED is glowing. Our next experiment is lamp driver. So for this we are going to build this connection, that is figure number 81, and for this we will use a SL100 NPN transistor to glow the lamp. So first I am giving plus 15 volt power supply to terminal 7 and minus 15 volt power supply to terminal 4. Now I am connecting the terminal 2 with a 10K potentiometer here Now ground the one terminal of 10k potentiometer and give the other terminal 15 volt power supply. Now I am connecting terminal 3 with the 10 ohm resistor and connect this with 15 volt power supply. Now from terminal 6, this is the output terminal, connect the base of the transistor. This is grounded and we will give 15 volt power supply here. Now, I am turning on the key and we can see as I am giving high input, the lamp is glowing. Our next experiment is offset adjustment in op-amp circuit. For this we will do the internal offset nulling experiment. So for this we are going to build this connection. So first connect terminal 2 with the 1k resistor and from here we will give input voltage. Now from here connect a 10k resistor and we will connect this with the output terminal, that is 6. Now we will connect 3 terminal with a 1k resistor and we will ground this. Now from terminal 1 we will connect 10k potentiometer here and this terminal of the 10k potentiometer will be connected to 5. Now we will give negative power supply to this terminal. Now we will give positive power supply to terminal 7 and negative power supply to terminal 4. Now when in input terminal the input voltage is 0, we can still get some output voltage at the output terminal. This is called offset voltage. So we are going to verify this. So this can be negative or positive. So connect this at the output terminal. So we can see this is the offset voltage although my input is 0.